eyes closed. And take a few deeper breaths, beginning that process of turning inward. And relaxing mind and body. Beginning that process of letting go. Trusting the memories and scenes as they come. You want to begin to imagine yourself in a place where you feel very safe and calm. And where is a place like that for you?
It's like in a jungle, and there's a waterfall, and there's a nice like swimming pond.
Take some time to, as vividly as possible, imagine being there. Really getting the feeling as though you're there. And then finding a spot there where you can sit or lie down. And go into a really deep meditative state. A state where your consciousness can expand beyond limits of mental mind. And to help you achieve that state, I'm going to count for you from 15 to 1. And with each number that I count, you want to relax more deeply, more profoundly. Fifteen, relaxing, releasing, letting go. Fourteen, going all the way down, deeper within and deeper relaxed. 13, allowing any sounds other than my voice to just fade into the background. 12, trusting the images, the impressions, feelings, memories as they come. 11, from time to time, I'm going to gently touch your right arm. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
As I do so, you'll find that it will assist you in going even deeper and in expanding consciousness even further. 10, deeper. Trusting all that your soul has to reveal to you. 9, deeper down. Just letting it happen. Good. 8. Inviting mental mind to step back, to release its grip. Because these memories come from deeper mind, and body, and soul. 7. Knowing that what we review, you've already been through. 5. Good. Consciousness expanding. 4. Three. deeper with that. Going to go on a journey back in time to explore some events earlier in your life. These are not things that you have to try to remember, but they are things that you can just simply allow to surface from deeper mind and soul. And to prepare for this journey back, you want to now allow yourself to be bathed in that healing, protective light that washes all down over you. Washes down over and through your head, quieting mental mind and expanding consciousness, taking it deeper and deeper. It flows down your back, through spine, through entire nervous system, soothing. Flows down over her chest, opening heart, a doorway to your inner world. And it flows down through belly, awakening intuition, inner wisdom and inner knowing. Flows down through hips and legs, feet and toes, until you're completely awash, aglow in this light, healing, protective light that takes you back now, back to that day when you're outside on the front porch. Just describe to me what it is that's happening there at this moment.
I can kind of see me, and I can see scaffolding on the side, and it's kind of like I'm looking like at a isometric view to the scene.
Okay. And describe yourself there on the steps for me, if you will.
I can see the, it's like that indoor-outdoor kind of carpet, it's brown, on the steps, and there's the wood railing.
Yes. And just slowly moving the scene forward, what is it that happens next?
Way up, the scaffolding like buckles in, and then it falls over, and I'm not even moving.
You're not moving. Scaffolding buckles in.
Yeah, it's falling. I can kind of hear it.
Hear it creaking.
Yeah.
And then what happens?
Over and hits the railing, skips, and hits me in the side of the head.
Hits you in the side of the head, and slowly now, what is it that happens next?
I can hear my mom screaming.
You're screaming.
Yeah.
You know what happens?
She's calling them fucking assholes for letting this happen.
Uh-huh. And where is she in relation to?
She's trying to open the front door, like the screen door.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm outside and she's pushing, trying to get some of the debris out of the way, and she pushes it out and then she lifts it up and like it slides down the stairs kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Before she lifts it up, what position is your body in?
I think I'm kind of like lying face down.
To that body that's lying face down.
I'm inside the house looking at it happen.
You're inside the house?
Mm-hmm. Like looking from behind my mom.
Mm-hmm. And what are your thoughts and feelings watching this from behind her?
I'm very calm.
Mm. She's not.
No, oh, she's frantic.
Calm.
And it's like this is supposed to happen.
It's supposed to happen. Help me understand that.
It's like it was planned beforehand.
And why was it planned that way? Why is this supposed to happen?
Work I have to do in this life.
Okay. So we're going to explore that more in a bit. But if you would first tell me what happens next, she's.
My guide is standing beside me.
Oh. Guide's beside you?
He just says, hey, it's going to be alright.
So he's reassuring.
Like, oh, I remember.
Mm.
I think there's like typically like a shocking sense of when this happens, but I understand already and know that it's okay, that I'm going to be okay. I'm not worried.
And meanwhile, what's mother doing?
She's pushed the stuff and she's on her knees and she's like holding me now. I get the sense that someone else is called an ambulance.
Mm-hmm. And are you just observing, or are you making any attempt to
kind of like
communicate with
her? I was kind of like sitting there with my arms crossed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then what happens next?
I can see the ambulance out front, and I see some people. Paramedics, blue shirt. They're pulling the stretcher up. And they move all the debris out of the way. I'm still inside the house looking at, or kind of more so in the doorway now, watching it happen. I feel like there's some like tether. Like a rope or something like that.
Tethered between you and
then my body.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like swinging around.
Mm-hmm. And then what do they do?
They see them like
what's happening with your body? What's it doing, if anything?
It's just sitting there. Mm-hmm. Get the sense that it's still breathing.
And you said the paramedic has a blue shirt on?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You might notice if there's any marking or name or something like that.
I think it's one of it. It says WFPS. Which is
WFPS?
See, like the, there's like a thing on the side of the shirt, like an emblem.
Is it just him, or is
there's two, two of them.
Okay. So they're fiddling with this board. It's awkward with your mom and the railings.
Mm-hmm.
Then what happens?
It's like a fire truck there too.
And are you aware of any things being said?
I feel like someone's talking to like the workers about what happened already. It's like there's neighbors around or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
I'm like floating up now and just like. Like way up, like just above the scene a little bit, like at the height of trees,
okay,
big elm trees.
Mm-hmm. And what are you thinking or feeling from this higher perspective? Neighbors, firemen.
More of a mess than I thought it would be.
And your guide, is your guide still there with you? Or?
Just kind of slaps her on the back. He's like, all right, you're good?
Mm-hmm.
I said, yeah, I got this. It's all good.
Moving forward, what happens next?
See, I'm loading me into an ambulance now, and I'm just like following along with the ambulance. I'm not inside of it.
How do you follow?
I just like float around with it.
Uh-huh. Above it?
Yeah, like above and behind it.
Mm-hmm. You might notice on the top of the ambulance there's usually a number or a marking.
Second.
No rush. Is the ambulance moving yet?
Yeah, it's like speeding down the street.
Uh-huh. And you're able to keep up?
Yeah, I'm following it. See it turning down one of the streets in my area.
And is mom at the house or is she in the ambulance?
She's in the ambulance.
Uh-huh. Yep.
And following along with it. Where they're gonna go, it's the hospital pretty close to my house.
Mm-hmm.
Just following along, they're like driving kind of through stop signs and everything.
Mm-hmm.
They're like slowing down as they get to them and they just keep going.
Mm-hmm. And are you able to go inside the ambulance, or do you just follow behind from outside?
Yeah, I can go in if I want to.
Mm-hmm. And what are they doing inside? What's happening in there?
It seems like they're just like taking my blood pressure. My mom is kind of sitting there just like very concerned. They're talking, I don't know what they're saying though.
Mm-hmm. And check the body, check breathing, heart.
I can see I got his mouth open like that.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's summer, I've got shorts on. A green shirt or something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. And how's the body doing? Mouth is open, I understand that. But heart and breath.
Seems to be okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And are you making any attempt to go back into it, or are you just
no?
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, what happens next?
Mm-hmm. They're like wheeling me in through the doors.
Mm-hmm. And as they wheel you in through the doors, where are you in relation to?
Stretch is like kind of like floating backwards along with it.
Mm-hmm.
Just like ahead of it, kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Ahead of it.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What happens?
But they inject me with something.
Oh. Where?
My arm.
Mm-hmm. Which arm?
My right arm.
Mm-hmm.
Go back.
Hmm. Tell me how that happens.
It's like you can imagine like a genie going in back into a bottle.
Hmm.
It's all like
enter from the forehead.
Sit up. They're telling me no, don't do that.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Just take a breath, kind of deep breath. Mm-hmm. So let's go back a little bit. Before you go back into that body, the guy slaps you on the back. And you say, "I've got this."
Mm-hmm.
So you might ask the guy why this was planned, why, how this is to help you with your work in the future.
He says it's to create a connection to the spirit world. It's like you're opening a wormhole or something like that to the other side. Visions, the same thing I saw yesterday. Me sitting in this office with someone lying down on a couch. I'm older, I've got glasses and less hair. Golden ball of like energy around myself and this person. And I can see there's all these shapes. Something to do with these shapes and colors is helping realign this person, helping them heal or something. I'm like using my hands to move these shapes and everything around.
Is anything confusing or anything about that you don't understand? You can ask him.
He says it'll be really revealed to you more in the future, but just know for now that this is what you do in the spirit world. You teach this.
Okay.
And then he says, I already told you about this. Why are you asking me again?
I wonder if there's one thing you could ask him. Having this, being hit by this metal scaffolding, opening a wormhole. Help you with your work. If why that was necessary, if there wasn't some way to come in with that open in the first place.
I think I like
ask
it's all. Yeah. I think he's showing me. Kind of making me feel like it's a delayed thing. The reason, like the way that this has worked for me is that it's supposed to be delayed. For some reason that this is a method to use in order to make it not happen right away. And that they wanted me to have like a completely normal life before figuring this out.
And if it was delayed, is there something that sort of activated it? Or?
That night in the car.
What's that?
That night in the car of the listening to the radio.
Oh.
About my commitment's work. It's like something unlocked That's what I felt. It's like something like rotated and clicked into place.
I see. So you might just take a few moments with that when you're in the car listening to Rich Martini. Something clicks in place that may be more there for you.
I feel like there's like this, again, this like connection that just made, that's made. It's like they were like the two sides were like this, and then when that happened, it was like. Powerful connection.
Just experience that, just feel that connection. Allow it to continue. I know this was a very important experience for you. Preparation for the work you're to do. And I'm wondering if in some way it's an important experience for your mother as well.
She's just, she was, it's by design why she's my mom.
Mm-hmm.
Like she can handle it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
She can handle it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, before we finish, is there anything more that you want to ask your guide, or anything more your guide wants to communicate with you at this time?
Just says keep on meditating.
Mm-hmm.
Get a sense that that's where I'm gonna learn more.
Anything more there that you want to explore, or does that feel complete?
That's good. The circle's kind of connected.
Circle's connected, yeah. In your own way, before we come back, you might just tell the little you who's there in the hospital that went through this, that body, that younger you, that all is going to be okay, that this was all for a purpose. You might just sort of inform him, even thank him for making it through that.
Putting my fingers on his forehead and on his chest. Tell him it'll be okay.
Yeah. And when that feels complete, take all the time you need and let me know.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Good. Knowing you'll have a renewed connection with your guide and access through this work. You can very gently, gradually return to finding even more details return to coming back to this day and to this date. time and place back to this room, this chair, your body, all the way up by the count of 5, 1, breathing, feeling into your body, 2, 3. We went back there.
It's like a missing piece of the puzzle.
Right. Yeah. No longer missing.
Nope. Got lots of work to do.
And you're doing it.
Freezing.
Cool. Yeah. Well,
thank you for that.
Thank you. Thanks everyone for holding the space.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.